Hopefully everything's good. Hopefully we're all kicking off. It's time for Jackaboy to go live, boy. I'm a tiny bit late. I sat down and I was like, okay, ready to go. And I was like, shit, haven't made a thumbnail or anything. I haven't made a thumbnail. Haven't updated the title. Haven't updated description, anything like that. So we're kind of bare bones at the moment, but we're on! We're live! Hello, everybody out there! All you beautiful people out there! We don't have game audio yet because... Boom jams. Are we good? Are we ready to go? Fuck yeah! 2 days in a row! 2 streams in a row! What is this? Hanukkah Christmas? Sure is! Just wanna make sure everything's okay. And nothing's broken. And I also want to leave a couple minutes for people to actually filter in. So we're gonna be playing Life is Strange Before the Storm, the new episode. I said last night in the Slime Rancher episode or live stream that I wanted to play this and maybe today, and why not? Fuck it. I don't want to record it today and then upload it and then have YouTube be like, ah, there's copyrighted music in this, and then have it go up the like 2 days later because of all the delays and everything. So why not just live stream it and do this? And plus, I've never live streamed a story driven game like this before, and now all of you get to be here to enjoy and partake in it as well, and you get to see it all live and see it all unfold as it goes down. Okay, everything seems to be okay. I want to tweet it out again, but it's going to do the thing where it's like, wait, last night for Slime Rancher I tweeted out and it said it was Final Fantasy 9, so I wonder if I tweet it out now, will it say that it's Slime Rancher? Okay, let's see. I'll tweet it from my phone. We're live with Life is Strange Episode 2. Come hang out and be hella cool. I never know what to tweet. What do you tweet? What do you make these tweets? What do you do with them? Nah, I'll just say Episode 2, it's... I can't fucking type. I hate touchscreens! It's gonna be hella tight. Here we go. What does it say? Does it say that it's Slime Rancher? No, Final Fantasy 9 again. I don't get it! What am I doing wrong? We need to look up that shit. But yeah, Episode 2 we're gonna be rolling into. We did Episode 1, Awake. It was okay. It was fairly good. It was just a little weird. And I'm not fully into it yet. I'm not as hooked on it as I was Life is Strange, the original. So I'm curious to see if Brave New World is any good. And people said that the ending to this is really good, and I don't know. And this, for any of you who are here now and need to go away or need to do something else, this should be going up as a full episode on the channel after this is done. Hopefully I can edit out this or something. If not, I don't know, because I want these to be like standalone things. Also, I should say a caveat right now. There's probably going to be minimal chat interaction during this, because I don't like it. I don't like when I see somebody upload episodes like this and they're constantly like looking over a chat and pausing the game and then like reading the chat and then coming back to the game or anything, especially for a story driven thing. And because I've done all the episodes before this as just standalone Let's Plays, and I've never actually streamed any of them, so I'm hopefully just gonna be powering through this and going through it normally, and then you guys just get to see me record it live, more or less, and then it'll go up as normal. Is that enough time? I don't know, because I want to do an intro and everything for this as well. Wait, let me just check. I want to make sure that levels are good. I'm going to have to turn up desktop audio a good bit. Just because there's going to be a lot of dialogue-heavy stuff in this, and I want to make sure that people can actually hear it. If you know what I mean. You know what I mean, dog? You know what I mean, dog? Let me just pop out the chat. So I'll still be looking over at the chat every now and then. It's just I probably won't be able to interact with it as heavily as I would like to. Where'd it go? Here we go. Make sure everything's in the right place. Here we go. Nice! The fucking carrots are back. God damn it. I also got myself some cider. Alright. Are we ready to go? Are we ready to kick it into high gear? I think so. Alright. Top of the morning to you laddies! My name is Jacksepticeye and welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm, Episode 2, A Brave New World. That's a mouthful to take in. I'm excited for this one. I really am, because I... Again, as I said, I wasn't too keen on the first episode. I wasn't too into it or anything. I don't know, I was into it, but there was just some parts of it that felt a little off and felt like I didn't connect with the characters immediately. Maybe it's because... I don't know. Maybe it's because Chloe's a different voice actress or anything like that. I don't know. I'm also live streaming this right now. So this might be a little weird, might look a little different or anything. All the people in chat, hello. All the people at home, hello, who are not here live. Let's do this. Brave New World. How do I start an episode? It's like, Brave New World, let's do this. And then you hit it, and then I don't actually start the episode.
Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm.
Ooh, plot.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
Hey, dickhead!
Get the fuck out of here!
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me.
Hello, Black Hal.
Chloe, do something!
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
I am!
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here. Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Damn, they are really going at it.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman? That was my dad.
This was a weird part. Because this to me looks like she has a power.
It was definitely not my mom.
That's a hella burning tree, yo. All right, here we go. Trespassing, drug use, sabotage, bullying. Am I in trouble with the principal?
Miss Price. How good of you to join us.
Does her mom
not
change her clothes?
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner and then... Just... Sorry.
Morning.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process. And the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and enrichment. When that respect
okay.
is violated...
reality check time. Yesterday when did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here.
Yep.
Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
That says it all.
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
Don't screw up.
Don't get in trouble again?
Trouble is merely the byproduct, Miss Price. What's at issue is your attitude. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
We did.
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, you engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language.
Fuck. I mean...
Witnesses saying you were involved in bullying Nathan Prescott.
The hell I was. I stood up for that little weirdo.
I suppose that's one interpretation of events.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Thanks, Mom.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
And Chloe's situation is less sensitive?
I do not discuss other students' situations. We are here to discuss your daughter and her actions.
Convenient.
Yeah. Reassure Mom or Cam Wells? Let's reassure Mom. Fuck Wells.
Mom, you know this is all bullshit, right?
I'm beginning to suspect that myself.
Oh!
I am sorry you feel that way, but your daughter's misbehavior is real and serious. And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
Oh, shit.
What does that mean?
It means... you forced
my hand. Am I expelled?
This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. I have no choice but to...
I made her do it.
What?
Oh,
what?
What? What? Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far.
Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me. You're better than this. But I wouldn't listen. See, Chloe was afraid I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me. But only to keep me safe. I'm just sorry you got caught up in it, Chloe. That you allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
A for acting. Well done. Well done. Of course.
Yeah, sure. We're cool.
We cool, homie.
Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe, is this true?
It's true.
Rachel's shirt
totally
was cool.
Not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Well done,
Miss Price.
Yeah, fine.
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel.
Ray.
Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
Coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like Rachel...
Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Awkward.
Do you have a list of students you assume the worst about?
Goad her on, and I'm just gonna sit back and enjoy the show, man. I got my cider. I'm just.
You have no right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it?
Let's all just calm down.
After everything she's been through in the last 2 years, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Miss Price.
Mrs. Price.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
I understand, Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
This is a dusty-ass office.
Miss Amber, I am as surprised as I am disappointed in you.
I understand.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time. But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period.
Oh, man.
And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
No! Not my acting!
No.
The performance is tonight. Jesus. I kind of want to say that, but I also want to call insanity. Shenanigans?
What? Are you insane?
Your discipline is still pending, Miss Price.
Ray, she loves that show. Since this is her first infraction, don't
Mr.
you
Amber,
think,
I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please don't tell me how to run my school.
Yeah, you dang cheater.
There's a reason we have understudies for all circumstances. accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy...
Victoria Chase.
Oh, fuck!
Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
Gross!
That is
such... What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next. Unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
Yeah, first of all, fuck you! Take the blame or go along with Rachel. Ooh! If I take the blame, I'll probably get kicked out of college, school, whatever. And then I'll probably go down a bad path with Frank and drugs and shit. We'll go along with Rachel and then we both suffer, but we might become closer friends? I'm gonna take the blame, man. I'm gonna be a good friend. Rachel! It's because of you! Because you wanted to be in that play tonight! I believe in you!
No way is Rachel missing the play for me. But thanks to her acting skills, I'll have to go down in flames if I want to fix this.
Oh, do I have to curse up a storm? Succeed in backtalk, listen to your opponent and choose a related comeback. Okay. I have to be the best at bullshitting my way through this. I have got to do some quality acting.
Okay, get here your we go. Head out of your ass, Wells.
Chloe, you seriously think yesterday was Little Miss Sunshine's idea?
Miss Amber has accepted her responsibility.
Okay. You are unacceptable. If it quag, accept reality.
Don't you have the slightest idea how this works? You don't wake up one morning and decide to be an outlaw. You need priors. You need training.
You need training
Rachel
to be an outlaw.
Confessed. Are you calling her a liar?
I confess that she can act. You should confess this one.
I confess to thinking she can act like a motherfucker. You just bought her crap. Hook, line, and sinker.
You don't have to do this. It's okay. Really.
Here we go. You don't tell me what to do. We're not friends. You do you. You don't tell me what to do. I don't want to say we're not friends.
Don't tell me what to do.
Yes.
I'm not one of your sycophants. I'm a lone wolf, and you're Little Red Riding Hood. Welcome to grandmother's house, bitch.
Chloe, this can't be you. Apologize this instant.
Oh, sorry for making you look bad. Shouldn't have dragged Rachel into it.
Fine.
Fuck.
I shouldn't have pulled Rachel out of class.
Fuck.
If I'd known she couldn't handle it, I would have gone it alone.
Why speak up, Miss Price? Your words do not exonerate Rachel, but they do further implicate you.
Oh, I only have one more chance. Oh, fuck.
This is my swan song. My farewell to Black Hell. I'm only sorry I had but one fuck off to give.
I've heard enough. Rachel, you were clearly trying to cover for your classmate. I appreciate the motive, but I appreciate honesty more. Is that understood?
And because your acting was so good, you're back into play.
You will not be removed from the play.
Yes.
Was that so hard?
Thank you.
And Miss Price, I came into today's meeting planning to suspend you for the rest of the school year.
Uh-oh.
With a chance for reinstatement in the fall.
Uh-oh.
And now?
You are expelled.
Oh, it's not what we wanted to hear.
What? No.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives.
Skip Matthews is not a real name. Come on.
That is all. Good day, Mrs. Price. Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
Well, that's us out of school for the rest of ever. It's okay. I didn't need it anyway. I'm a free bird.
I'm sorry. Nothing to be sorry about. Meet me at the junkyard later? You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price?
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
A lot of very familiar voices bouncing around in this episode.
Mom,
I'll see you in the parking lot.
Oh shit, we're gonna get beat down.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Oh, Skip Matthews.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip.
You know I was supposed to have today off, right?
Sorry that my totally fair and impartial hearing inconvenienced you, man.
Yeah, what the fuck, Skip Matthews? Skip Matthews, really? Your name isn't even real.
I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here.
Hell yeah, dog. I might not be in high school anymore, but I can definitely get high as a motherfucker after this.
I had big plans for adding to this collage. Oh well.
I'm glad you didn't get to. That looks like a fucking... the inside of a My Chemical Romance album. Let's take a picture of a cat, though. Why are the edges all burnt? Okay, pretty kitty. Homework. I get to do what I've always wanted to do. Trash the homework! Fuck you, school! My dog didn't eat my homework all that time! It was me! Okay, I thought you were actually gonna make a bigger deal out of it instead of just throwing it in the bin.
Trusty keeper of my graffiti pens. You've served me well.
Who talks like this? That's pretty cool. I like that one. Let's take my chemistry book so I can learn how to make a bomb. Or not. Hey, Skip. How's it going, buddy? You fake name. Geometry. Hey, Skip. You want to know something about geometry? Watch this. Simple geometry. Okay, where's my joint? Also, those books cost a lot. Maybe sell them off and give some money back to your mom. Just trying to be a good kid.
Oh, secret hidden jointaroo.
You see nothing, Skip Matthews.
Jackpot.
Wait. Cause it's mine!
What the hell?
I'm Jack and this is my pot! Jackpot!
Damn it, Justin.
Chloe, heyo! Had to borrow your stash. Desperate times, you know? I promise I get it back to you next week. Justin. Justin, I am going to pull your testes off. That was my joint. I'm having a rough day, Justin.
Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me.
Bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
When you say you wanted to tag the place, did you mean you wanted to pee on it? You gonna pee all over the school? Oh yeah, here we go. Yes, I know she meant tag as in write all over it, but... in sub! Ordinate! Man! I am good! I'm really good at drawing! Why am I wasting my time away in school? Oh man, there will be consequences. I saw Max's name there. Also, I didn't realize last time the shirt that I'm wearing is Max's, I think, from the first one. I'm leaving, Rachel. This is how I get away with it, because everybody else is technically writing these. I'm just writing down their quotes. This is also fun.
Fighting over
this the Brave New World? Outside of school? You're trying too hard, Frank. You're pathetic, biker, bitch, skeevy guy. It's all skeevy guy had to his name. He just said bitch. It's a Victoria. Wanna see what I wrote about you? Yeah, see you later. I'm out. Peace. Deuces. Don't need school. All I need is my jackpot. Also, just tell your mother the truth that you lied to get Rachel to do things and then Rachel still gets to act in the play and then afterwards. Oh, hey, Bigfoot. I found him. Hello? I found him. Bigfoot. Big face. Drug-free zone.
Later, Skip.
Yeah, later.
Later.
Skip Matthews. Come on. It's not a real name.
Looks like David's here. Awesome.
Sweet. Love David. Okay. Come on. I want to go back to the top and read it. Are we cool? Did you stop? We should probably sleep. Got Wells tomorrow morning. Yeah, my fault. Worth it. Hashtag worth. Wells blows. That meeting hella sucked. There it is! They said it! They said the hella thing! It's always in a... It became a meme in this fucking game. You're hella weird! Dudes, I'm hella lol random! No, you are! Seriously, it's okay. Yesterday was hashtag worth. Am I a cool kid yet? Is this how all you teens talk? Have I missed out on the team brigade?
Max would have loved this shit.
Max sure does love shit. The future needs excellence. Because of a generous grant from the Prescott Foundation, Blackwell will be offering several new courses next fall designed to nurture the artistic gifts of its students. Art 101, visual concepts. Intro to the composition, intro to ceramics, intermediate Photoshop, intro to the character modeling and animation. This is fucking awesome! If you have any of these things at your school, I highly recommend doing them. Such creative courses. Stuff like that didn't exist when I was going to school. I didn't get to do any things like visual concepts. Especially not in high school, that's kind of what college was for. And then I went to do music and all half of this shit was in it. Like visual concepts and intermediate Photoshop and I was like, and photography. I had a photography class in my hotel management course. Or not my hotel, my music thing. And I was like, I don't care. I don't want to learn about photography. Now I would love to. Because of YouTube and everything, and the Photoshop stuff I was doing in college, I was like, I don't care! I wanna bang drums! Bang bang boy, wanna hit the boom booms! But, man, if you had this in your school, that's so awesome. I wish I got to do it. How's it going? Oh, hey! Hey, Douglas. Elliot, I mean.
Hey,
what's
Elliot?
Up?
What brings Chloe Price to school on a Saturday morning? Nothing good, I bet.
I was expelled.
Wait, really? Holy shit!
I know. I'm surprised it took this long, too.
Do you want a hug?
Okay. Thank you, Elliot.
Okay.
Oh, this is gonna be cringe. Oh, it totally is!
Thanks.
Oh, amazing.
Was Rachel Amber involved?
Yeah.
And let me guess, did she get off scot-free?
Well, yeah. But she tried to cover for me.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, what are you doing here?
I thought I should come early to grab tickets.
To the play?
For the Tempest? You said we might see it together.
I did?
Right. Good call.
Who the fuck is
did
Elliot?
Did you get my text about hanging out afterwards?
I'm gonna be ditching the show, Elliot. It's not you. It's me. Got expelled. Also, have a whole lot of weed to smoke.
Actually, I was thinking maybe I won't go to the Tempest.
The more I think about being at Blackwell tonight, the more I want to throw up.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. I should have thought of that. Do you just want to hang out instead?
Nah, I think I'll just chill at home. You don't mind, right?
It's totally cool. No problem.
That's a lie.
Next time. Okay?
He totally minds.
I better go. My mom is waiting to stick her attack mustache on me. Her boyfriend. Don't worry about it. See you around, Elliot.
Some of the dialogue in this game is so bizarre.
Later.
He's like, fuck! Thought I could get some weed! That's hella not cool, Chloe! Alright, let's go talk to Freddie Mercury over here.
It's about damn time.
David, please.
Yo! How's it going?
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
That's a change. No? Okay. Can we please do this later?
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here.
I was going with Captain Buzzcut.
Do
That's a good one.
Not use that language with your mother.
She's my mom. I own her.
Or what, David? What will you do?
You do not want to test me. Maybe if you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? Like how to have no job? Or how to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You don't want to be a loser, do you, Chloe?
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner?
Do you want to work at the diner and have a shit job like me? Also, Chloe had a scholarship? What did Chloe have a scholarship for? Huh. Probably being hella dope. Someone needed my help, nothing wrong with that. Yeah, nothing wrong with that, Mom.
There's nothing wrong with waiting tables, Mom.
Chloe, I'm proud to wait tables because it means you can be whatever you want to be. But what is that, Chloe? What do you want?
Maybe... I don't know yet.
What a good mom.
Maybe you've had long enough to figure it out. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I care about Joyce very much. I'm willing to forgive you for the incident yesterday. If you improve your attitude going forward.
Incident? What incident?
Chloe was incredibly out of line. She insulted me. Swore at me.
Nuh-uh.
But with an apology, I'm willing to start over.
You know what? It's been a long day. And for Joyce. For my mom. Look at her face. Not his face. Her face. Go back to Joyce. Can we go back to Joyce? Kick it on over to Joyce. Yeah, well, we got her profile, so that's enough.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
Ah, lame. How else will I be a cool kid?
Mom.
Chloe? I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
You have the right to remain silent.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe, and I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
We... feel this is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. quit Stalin.
I'm not Stalin, I'm Mussolini. That's a joke. I mean, I don't have any drugs on me. So we should be okay, right? Please don't tell me I have any drugs on me.
Fine. You want to see my shit so badly?
Takes out actual poop. Flare gun, cigarettes, whoopee cushion, and a picture of a kitty cat. Here we have the First Amendment. And the Declaration of Independence. That was even better!
You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
David, come on, man.
Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
Oh, I forgive you. You, but not him. Yeah, I'ma go with that one. Cause screw this mustache-wearing motherfucker. Then what are you seeing him, Joyce?
Sure. As long as you promise to never speak to this asshole again.
Chloe.
Oh, no can do, Chloe.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
It's like the developers are talking directly to me. Tell me what you're feeling in this moment! Here comes a choice. Pick wisely. But, okay, first of all, I thought David was living with them already. Am I silly for thinking that? I mean, I guess last, in the original game, he was living with them, but... he was outside the house, and I kinda just assumed? I don't know, man. I don't know which one to pick. Neither of these seem to give any sort of indication as to where this conversation is gonna go. I know I fucked up, or you're trying, I get it. I know I fucked up.
Mom, I know I fucked up. I'm a fuck up. I'm sorry.
Are you sorry? You don't even know what you're apologizing for.
True.
I've been shutting you out even though I've needed you, and you need me, and I know that. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
Eesh.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
Man. Life's hard when you're hashtag 15 years old.
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
Man. It's tough, Chloe. I get it. It would have been much easier if we had that joint.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down?
That's deep. That's a Jaden Smith tweet.
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
And Rachel Amberlamps.
What a nice boat.
Good kiddos. That's a creepy sign. Hurt your hands if you went hitting that with a baseball bat. Have you ever hit something with a baseball bat that's not a baseball? Hurts like fuck.
Ugh.
What are we doing?
This thing is a mess, but maybe I can fix it.
What?
If this
Why?
Beast will ever run again, the first thing it needs is a new battery. Wonder if I can find one around here.
Okay, let's read message from our moms. Two new messages. Oh. ABFW alert. Fire weather update. Arcadia Bay Forest Watch. Active Class D wildfire, not contained. Use caution. Check local media for a closure.
That might have been us. Oops.
Will you be joining us for supper? No, thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home after curfew? There will be consequences. Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. Love you. Your school called. I think you know why. We have a meeting tomorrow with Principal Wells. I need you to do better. Chloe, I'm worried about you. Please let me know you're okay. Okay? Chloe, did you hear there's a fire? Please text me so I don't worry. Chloe, are you okay? Chloe, please. I'm fine. Oh, thank goodness. Come home by curfew. We have that meeting early tomorrow. Oh, that was yesterday. Again, Chloe, really? Chloe, you can't keep doing this to me. I'm trying my best. Chloe, David's trying to do what he thinks is best. He's such a tool. I didn't like that he asked you to empty your pockets. And then you were completely innocent. Chloe, can't you just forget about David for a second? Think about me. Maybe I just need space, okay? Maybe I need my daughter back. Holy shit, did you get Wells' text about fire? Are you okay? I'm just in my room. Hey, after Tempest, do you want to hang out? It's not going on, okay? And this is just about the fire. Alright, fair enough. Let's go get a battery.
Guess I was pretty pissed at Rachel last night. Amazing that someone I just met could have made me this angry.
You didn't really just meet her, though. You knew who she was. Battery. Where I find a battery? Probably inside another fucking car. Dad's car.
No, not going over there.
I'm already there. Ooh, a boat. Can we get a boat battery? A boatery? Oh my god.
Damn, you cigarettes.
Cigarettes do not make you have less upper body strength. Getting out of breath, maybe, but it was not the out of breath that failed you there, Chloe.
These magazines are so gross. Gross.
Okay, that's boobs.
Who would look at this? I know one fire that doesn't need any poking.
What? What does that mean? Oh, wait, yeah, the fire in the forest. Never mind, I thought it was some sort of like, I know one fire that doesn't need a poking. Thaler. Alright, pirate flag! Pirate Price.
Pirate flag? Wonder if there's treasure buried nearby.
Arr! There'll probably be some doubloons lying around.
Director of curriculum at Blackwell Academy.
Right. Okay, how about I just run away down the train tracks? Never to come back. Ever. Alright, let's look around a bit more. Gotta find a battery.
I think I'm all smashed out. For now.
That's what she said. Come on, babe, let me smash!
Sorry, Max. I think I'm more jealous of you than anything. Hopefully, I'll be escaping this place soon, too.
Maybe. Glass shards!
Glass looks way prettier when it's broken. Wonder what else that's true for.
Noses, windows, though I guess technically that's still glass. Also, what a weird thing to say.
This rug has some miles on it.
Why is this a thing in the game? Why is that a thing that can happen? Why are you making me look at nonsense items and then having nonsense dialogue that goes nowhere? Just don't have it be a thing. No, investigate. Time to homes this shit.
This is no good.
Okay. Good investigating. Man, but that was the only one I could actually click into. Can't even check the rest of these. Maybe I missed a route. Aha, all the way down here. School bus!
I guess I'll never ride one of these again. That's so awesome.
It is a pretty good feeling when you don't have to go to school anymore.
You're a long way from the beach.
Again, why? 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 No one cares. Ooh, this is actually a fully functioning car.
This thing looks somewhat new. Maybe the battery still works?
Maybe.
What are you trying to hide under their hood?
Are you trying to hide red riding? Good effort. Last time I opened up the bonnet of a car, you had to prop it up. Careful, careful, careful. Nice.
Here we go. The pick of the litter.
That's a pretty good battery. Okay, I want to read the police notice. Where did I put the battery? I hid it. Ghost battery!
Wow. Shitty ride, drug dealer. We thought crime paid better.
Okay, let's click this to read. Warning! This vehicle has been seized and impounded in execution of a warrant order. This vehicle is distrained and impounded in accordance with the authority provided by Rule 42. Is Rule 42 the rule that means that anything on the internet will and does have porn of it? Of the Oregon Magistrates Court rules in pursuance of Section 2 Narcotics Act. I don't care. I don't care. You gave me the battery I need. You will give my Jeep the life it deserves. Thank you, fair maiden. Away I go to give life yet again. It says Anne Bonnie on the license plate. Oh, that's Rule 34, yeah. Got it. Yikes. What do I say about being careful? Did it. Regular old MacGyver. Anything? Whoa.
Damn.
Oh, my controller's vibrating.
This thing needs more love than I can give right now.
That was weird.
In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit.
I was like sitting here and I had my hands on my table on my mouse. And as soon as she hit the ignition, my table started vibrating. I was like, oh, that's weird. Maybe it's my fan over here, like rubbing against the table. And then all of a sudden it started again as soon as she hit the thing again. I was like, what's vibrating? Am I in the car? And then all of a sudden I realized my controller's still plugged in, so that makes sense.
Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here.
Is this really what the game is right now? Am I doing up a car?
Probably a good idea to cover over this with something.
Doesn't it look like the map of the world?
While an escape hatch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole.
Maybe. Might be smart. Oh, hey, Chloe. That was weird. Okay. I think we got a message. Who's messaging me? Rachel. What's up, Rocky? Grab me something from home, then I'll meet you at the junkyard. See you really soon. You better. Alright, am I going searching around?
No, I can't.
Okay. What was the button to check my... Oh, there we go. Find more to fix. I don't know what that means. You really have no upper body strength, Chloe. Okay, there we go. Ah, now we can get into the boat. Up we get. Oh, oh.
Shit.
Yeah, that's a big fire. Yikes. Clouds are cool looking though. Cabin! It's cool that you can still hear the music playing when I turned it on. That's neato burrito.
Rachel set that fire.
Relax.
I don't think she meant to, but I also don't think she didn't mean to.
Sure.
What do I want to tell my fellow sailors of the seven trash heaps?
Bury treasure or burial grounds? Bury treasure, of course! It's a pirate ship! You gotta talk about buried treasure! X marks the spot! Radical practical. Radical piratical. Is an achievement I just got. I don't know if that actually shows up. I don't think it shows up on the stream. Wow. A lot of stuff in here. We'll get back to you, Dad, you big cheater. Is this all I can do up here? That was for an achievement? Man! And we're down. Superhero landing. Toy robot! Hi, Bulbot!
Light the way, Robobulb.
I love you, Bulbot!
Destroy! Destroy!
Aw, poor dude.
I know one fire that doesn't need any poking.
Yeah, we've been here. Need something to cover over a big hole. A putting green.
Four. Or something.
Solid effort, Chloe. An effort was made. Wait, wasn't there something else I needed? Oh yeah, something to cover over the hole and something to cover over the seats. So let's see. Let's fill it up. Do you think that's what people that are called Phil say before they do something? It's like, oh, it's time to fill it up! Like, I jack it up. Oh, I could say that. You're right there, Chloe. Ladies and gentlemen, we fucking did it. Oh, now it's gonna be all blue and awesome in here. Alrighty, cool. Torn seat. I need something for that. Ba-da-ba. Ba-da-ba. Dad's car. Don't need that. Ooh, what's in the box? What's in the box? Is that a little Frank Sinatra? I want it. Okay, I don't think that fixes the torn seat, but it's good enough. You're coming with me, Tiny Frank Sinatra. Okay, can't take that. Beach towel!
This could cover that torn seat and look awesome doing it.
Now I get it. Now I get why these things are here. Okay, might have been a bit too harsh on the game in regards to those, but you know! That is a bunch of stuff out there that just makes no sense as to why it's clickable, but okay, I'll take that one. I'll admit fault on that one.
Love me tender, love me true. I am fixing you.
Ah, hippy dippy, love it. It's all about the color, innit? Wait, what do I get to put the Tiny Frank Sinatra on?
You can hang here. But I get to pick the tunes, okay?
Okay.
Good talk. This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. Probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable.
You gotta keep trying!
Still, how sweet would that be?
Cue Rachel. Is that her?
Yeah.
Price, it's Frank.
Oh.
Hey, Frank. What's up?
Yeah, just checking in to see how you're doing.
Really?
No. Listen, we've got some business to discuss. Where can we meet?
What about? Oh, like drugs?
Price.
I'm hanging out in the junkyard, north of town.
The junkyard? That's great. Stay there, I'll see you soon.
Okay. And Frank?
Burner phone, or is everything cool?
I'm not in trouble or anything, right?
I don't know. Did you do anything you should be in trouble for?
Like, in general?
As the fire looms in the background.
I'll see you soon.
Alright. bitchin' phone, by the way. Flip phones need to make a comeback.
Time for a hard-earned smoke break.
Dome light, turn on.
Looking good, Robobulb.
Nice. Let's honk that horn. Who wants to see me honk a horn? Who? I do. Honk, honk. Honk, honk. Do it. Nice. I kind of wish it was the... You know? That'd be fun. Singing man. Let's bobble him.
Does Principal Wells eat pizza with a fork and knife?
What?
I knew there was something off about that guy.
Oh, you're agreeing with me, okay. We could graffiti.
You only get one chance to make a first expression.
Mystical or frightening? Frightening for show! Mystical would have went well with the colors, but frightening is always my go-to state of being. Rawr! Did I get ya? You
this
are about
will
to
give
dip.
Intruders something to think about.
So, I said put down something frightening, and you wrote, you are about to dip. That's not frightening. That's not frightening at all. That's stupid. Fine, let's smoke. Smoke our stupid away. Oh, that's a pretty song.
I'm trying to reach.
Wait, did it say die? And not dip? Did I read it wrong?
There's a hole in the earth.
Oh, it does say die. Come on! It looks like a P! It looks like dip! I thought she was making a reference to the towel and then saying like you're gonna take a dip. You're gonna die. That's okay, that's more frightening. A little on the nose, no subtlety to it, but at least it's not dip. Oh, I'm so stupid. Maybe I should smoke the stupid away. It's embarrassing. I like songs like that. Is that by Daughter again? Because they did some of the songs in the first episode. Which all got copyright claimed. Immediately. So that episode just was copyright claimed for the entirety of being up in the channel, but... good music! Chloe Price,
shit.
You were about to die!
I slept all day.
No, you're dreaming. Watch out, Chloe! You're about to dip!
What the hell?
Yeah, I know it says die now! Oh, jeez. Oh, we're hallucinating again. Is your dad making s'mores with his own flaming car with a crow? A crow named Orson? If I was the principal, I'd have a crow or a pet named Orson so I could say it's Orson and Welles.
Dad?
Sit down, Chloe. You need to marshmallow out. Not gonna lie, this is... it's pretty creepy. Okay, we took a stick. That's cool. Can I have a marshmallow? Here we go. Don't question it. Just go with it. marshmallows roasting on the hood of the car that my dad died in, and now he's sitting next to me like a ghost. Orson nipping at your nose. Dad, get off! Am I going to dip?
Amazing, isn't it? I can't look away.
Sure.
Don't pretend you're not mesmerized too.
This is weird. I like this.
See? You're so drawn to it, you don't even realize the danger.
Danger?
Wait, is the fire actually getting closer?
Us. Just like darkness. But darkness blinds with absence. With loss.
What does fire blind with?
Beauty.
Oh, creepy.
But sometimes, there's a greater beauty yet to come.
Whoa. Incredible.
Fire is jealous, Chloe. It wants all the beauty for itself. That's why you need to be careful.
Careful of what?
Of getting burned.
Gross! My dad was Two-Face! Fucking weird! I thought she was gonna like wake up and the fire would be right next to her all of a sudden. Rachel? Sorry.
Hasn't anyone ever told you not to fall asleep with a lit cigarette? You could start a fire.
You wanna come dip?
So, are you gonna invite me in? Or what?
I'm not sure. Are you lit like my cigarettes?
I love giving rides to strange drifters. Hop in. Thanks.
What's in the bag? Did you run away from home?
Damn, you've been busy.
It's nothing. Just some junk I found lying around.
A rainbow towel? A cool blue light? That is dark.
Too dark?
Perfect dark. Chloe, this is incredible. I can't believe you found us an escape vehicle already.
Escape?
Like, for us to run away? Oh, I guess I wasn't thinking about it that way.
Are you getting cold feet? I thought you were all bye-bye Arcadia Bay last night.
I still am, I guess.
You guess?
It's not so easy. This truck doesn't even start, and we don't have any money.
We can figure all of that out. I have no doubt. Besides, there's no rush.
True. And no Blackwell.
Holy shit. That Wells meeting. I'm so sorry. I can't believe he actually expelled you.
Why not? No reason to prolong the inevitable.
It's definitely Blackwell's loss. Aww. You covering for me was amazing. I don't know how to thank you.
Whatever. You tried to cover for me too.
Tried and failed. I guess we know who the better liar is.
Yeah, I should be in the play.
Or maybe my lie was the one he wanted to believe.
At least Wells has no idea what really went down with us last night. Shit got pretty wild.
pretty wild?
Rachel, that was more than pretty wild. You went absolutely nuts last night. What the hell were you thinking?
I was angry. I didn't expect the whole stupid park to go whoosh. But now you're in on it too. Accessory after the fact. Unless you tell on me, of course.
I'm no snitch. I'd be way happier going to jail than having to live at home with Dictator David. He announced his plans to move in this morning.
That's a pretty good one. Dictator.
Chloe, that's awful. I'm so sorry.
That sounds awesome.
You know what we both could use? Therapy.
Therapy.
You start. Kick back and tell me what's bothering you.
Well, it all started off when my dad died. That was probably the instigator for all of my bad behavior. And then I smoked some weed and drew graffiti. I threw a chemistry book away. And then I hit things real hard with a baseball
bat. Back.
Let's start with David.
There's this dildo with a mustache who's been dating my mom, and now he thinks he's moving in with us. How do I stop him?
That's a hard one. I'm not sure there's really anything you can do.
Then what the hell am I talking to you for?
Just because you can't stop him doesn't mean you don't fight back. The resistance begins now. All right. You're going to need a new nickname to mark your enemy. What have you got?
Step douche, step fuck, step dick. Step fuck, it's a pretty good one. It just feels like it's a little on the nose, don't you think? It's a little just like right there. Step douche, I like that one. But step dick might take the kick. I like the step douche and step dick because it kind of sounds like step dad has that D sound rolling right into it. Step douche, a little long. Step dick. Dick could technically still be his name. Dick David. Sounds pretty good.
He's a step dick because he's overly sensitive and he thinks he's way more important than he is. Also, he's a dick.
Poetic. Yeah. May I also suggest stepladder?
Why stepladder?
Because he climbs on your mom every night.
Ew!
And pretty soon, they'll be stepping down the aisle.
What the hell kind of therapist are you?
Sorry. It's called shock therapy.
Ow!
Highly controversial.
Oh! Rachel! Rachel takes the cake! Rachel did it! She did it! She picked the best one! She did it! She got a good one! How did she do that? Here's me deliberating over it for fucking ages, and all of a sudden it was just like, step ladder, because he climbs on your mom every night. Oh, Rachel, you're so good at this. Ooh, let's see what else she got.
So, my new friend, who everyone thinks is perfect, did something batshit fucking nutso last night.
That's Rachel.
What do I do?
This perfect friend of yours, who I'm assuming is also an exceptional beauty, sounds like she may have been inspired by someone new in her life. Someone who is also, may I add, a knockout in the looks department. Perhaps this friend of yours, who, I reiterate, must be just stunning.
We get it.
Needed someone in her life to teach her.
How to steal wine from yuppie picnickers?
How not to give a fuck. Because she was tired of having to give so many fucks all the time.
That makes sense.
Yuppie picnickers sounds like something that you shouldn't be allowed to call people. It sounds really bad.
I've been booted from school, and I'm not entirely sure what to do about it.
You mean how to cope with your feelings of anger and disappointment?
No. I mean, how to express my feelings of intense joy.
Uh-huh. Do you think you might be taking this a little too well?
You tell me. I'd say I'm exceptionally well-adjusted.
I'd say I'm taking it
I'd
black
my
well.
Therapist's license that no one's ever called you that before.
Touché, Doc.
You yuppie picnicker.
That was actually somewhat therapeutic. Thank you.
It's always a pleasure delving into the mind of Chloe Price.
And now it's your turn. Tell me all about what it's like being daughter of Arcadia Bay's most famous scumbag.
Oh, yeah.
It sucks. Too blunt? Sorry. I do that sometimes. Nah, I'm just... ugh, I don't know.
They're cute.
Can we talk about something else? Of course.
Wells, fire truck.
Hey, you ever try picturing what Principal Wells does when he's not at school? I see, like, a bed covered in teddy bears, and he's tying a little necktie around each one. That's weird.
Yeah.
I'm a weirdo.
Okay. End of conversation, I guess.
Do you think
there we go.
There's a point when you've been acting so much that you don't even have your own personality anymore? You're just whatever you think other people want you to be.
Oh, you mean a YouTuber?
I think you have a personality.
Or some YouTubers, I should
say.
I
wasn't talking about me. My dad doesn't really exist. You saw him in Wells' office. The whole thing is a performance. And now I'm starting to feel like everything in my life is bullshit. But he's still my dad. How can I make sure I don't end up like him?
Maybe don't cheat on your mom?
You couldn't be like him even if you wanted to. You're too awesome. The fact that you believe that makes me feel better.
Aww.
Shit, it's time for the play. As if my life didn't have enough drama in it. Good luck. You know you're never supposed to tell an actor good luck before a show? It's bad luck.
How is telling someone good luck bad luck?
You're supposed to say, break
a leg. Is that why they say break a leg?
That's dumb.
Hey, I was thinking that after the show, maybe we could go do something. Just you and me.
Something criminal?
Criminally fun.
Ooh.
I'm in.
I like the sounds of that. I'm into fun. I can be very fun.
Wait, you forgot your bag. It's for you. Just a little survival kit for your new life on the lam. Drive safe, Chloe.
Finger guns. Wait, I'm caught in my headphone cable. Finger guns. Hey, we're back here. This is in the first season of Life is Strange.
Hello, Junk Shack.
Oh, a message from Mikey. What's up, Mikey? Ack, I heard you got expelled, sorry. Yeah, I rolled a 1 against Wells. Get it? Steph says you're a nerd.
Time to check out Rachel Amber's mystery bag.
Ooh! Let's hang up the tapestry! Does it convey my emotions in a very timely manner? That's an elephant!
Welcome back,
I guess we should talk about the elephant in the room. I make a yoke.
So if you're planning on heading,
I stick up a sign. Wrong way. I want to get a sign for outside my room, outside this recording room, that I can just hang up out there. Not that one. That one says be more positive. I want to have one up outside that either says stage door, because I just saw one in Brighton earlier that said stage door on it, and I was like, that's kind of fun. But I also want one that says caution, loud noise.
It's like my junk fortress of solitude.
Okay, I'm gonna turn you off for a sec, just so I can think. Let's hang the dartboard. Do I have any darts? I would love to play some darts. Nice. Looking good, dartboard. Okay, what's in the bag? What did Rachel bring me? Please be crisps.
A bag full of clothes.
I can't eat them. I mean, I can try, but...
Yes, I need those.
I don't want to. I don't want to eat clothes. Try on. I got to change my outfit
Nothing
again.
Nothing like an abandoned shack in the middle of a junkyard to make a girl feel like exploring a new wardrobe.
I mean, yeah. Tarot Tower, bonus outfits, or Rorschach Skull. Rorschach Skull is pretty fucking cool. Bird Skull, Classic Chloe. Nah. I'm gonna go with Rorschach Skull.
I want a skull. I want it right there on my chest.
Oh, and I got new pants. I think I'm looking pretty metal! Sorry. Had to be done. I have a bird in my chest that looks like a skull. That's metal as fuck. I'll meet you if you have the cash. Again, rain check. I'm at the junkyard now. But I'm at the junkyard. Frank? Frank? Frank! I don't think he's here. Wait, hold on a sec. I can do this. Frank!
That's the woman we saw with Rachel's dad.
Oh. Who dat?
Weird.
Yo, Frank. It's Chloe. I don't know the secret password, man. Is the password drugs?
Price, get your ass in here.
Password was drugs. The volume was too high. Sorry. My bad.
Dude, it smells like piss in here.
Shut up.
You have a rough night or something?
Every night's a rough night. I've got a notebook in the back somewhere. Go get it for me, would you?
I want to write my feelings into it. Whoa.
God. Jeez, man.
Get my notebook, Price. Then we'll talk.
Wait, did you roll up into the junkyard with a whole RV?
No, I'm fetching.
And then a girl got out
Frank.
And went somewhere?
Hello, can I?
Dude, I heard you got expelled. Bad news. You mean good news? I'm stoked. Word. I'm home too. Finally got busted yesterday for smelling like weed. My mom's making me go to her boat group. Oh man.
I go.
Good talk, buddy.
What does Frank really need to remember?
I'm a graffiti on this. Beer, TP, and milk. Work.
Got it.
What you got, Fisher Price? Chloe's droogs. Sod it.
Wait, Frank got a puppy?
Oh, no.
For real?
Don't make me remember the poor dog. Oh, I got that dog killed. Oh, no. Okay, I can't read into it. Wait, there was more on this.
Poor Frank. Oh, man. Rachel the therapist would have a field day with this.
Saturday, May 8th. Dream about clouds, meaning. What age will dog eat steak? Are these things he's searching? Oh yeah, it's history. Pisshead music. Mila Kunis single. Megan Fox single. Property insurance fire illegal. How large was biggest cloud in history? Oh, Frank, you're precious! Frank, we love you! Oh, poor Frank.
Shit. The mill burned down.
Ball Crusher 348. More fucking shit. Frank, I went back to the mill. Shouldn't have. I'm fucking furious. Everything's burnt. Total massacre. Can't stop thinking about it. Dogs didn't make it. That's 10k gone just like that. Plus the stud fees we had coming. RF and that whole crew are gonna be pissed. How am I supposed to come back from this with my fucking reputation intact? I can't think straight on this shit right now. I just want to find someone that started the fire this fucking...
Jeez. That's an expensive dog.
$3,000 for a dog? From Damon.
Matt Damon.
What's up, Frank?
It's always hard to tell what Frank's thinking.
He's probably thinking, man, I'm awesome. Also, shit, I should look at the road. Ooh, what's in your frig?
Frank must be spending hundreds of dollars on this dog.
What the fuck? Or maybe he just really loves steak.
Don't mind if I do.
Don't even fucking think about it.
Damn.
I wasn't gonna, anyway.
I'm busted.
Okay. Is the dog back here? Please be cute puppy pooch.
Please, 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 please be a dog.
Whoa! Yeah!
Hey there.
Oh!
It's okay, little guy.
Aw, oh, shit. Pompidou, get up here.
His name is Pompidou. He's so cute.
Pompidou.
You little killer.
Oh my god, I want him. And now he's just asleep. Oh, he's so adorable. Still can't believe you got expelled. If you need someone to talk to, let me know. Or if you want another hug.
Aww.
I think I'm good for now. Ha ha. Seriously, I am here for you. Cool.
Thanks.
Thanks, Elliot. Good looking out. Okay.
Frank and his BFF. That's adorable.
It is pretty cute. Frank's adorable. I like Frank. Little Pompidou.
Is this what I think it is? Ah, shit. I'm in the red.
I owe $175. Technically, you're not in the red, because people with their names crossed off have red on them. Stella Drew Jackson.
Time to find out what Frank wants to discuss.
Frank's knife?
A swingy, flippy instrument of death.
It's called a knife. Switchblade. Flip knife, whatever you want to call it. That's a cool computer background. That's trippy. Here you go, Frank! Oh, wait. Betting slip.
Oh, man. I hope Argus and Bowser are okay.
Oh.
Is this it?
Have a seat.
Pompidou, huh? That's one badass name for a dog.
I think it's adorable.
It's French.
French for what?
Does it mean, like, tough guy or something?
Do I look like I speak fucking French?
French people! What does Pompidou mean?
Okay, so who was that woman?
What woman?
The one I saw coming out of your RV.
Oh yeah, I meant to introduce you. Her name is Mind Your Own Fucking Business.
Oh. I could Elsa my way out of this. Could just let it go. Let it go. But I'm gonna demand an answer.
Rachel would want to know more. I bet I can convince Frank it's harmless to tell me. Dude, I'm just curious. What's the big deal?
Idiot. I make money by being discreet.
Frank's icon is a tin of beans. Shit.
No shit, Frank. You think I don't know about hiding things from other people? I'm a teenager.
Come on, Price, I gotta protect my clients. Happy customers are the foundation of a good business.
Her name has to be in the thing. Dream Cloud, it's about drugs, build our relationship.
Your customers like you because you're laid back. That's why I like you. So you should keep building up that easygoing vibe, you know?
Sure, I guess. So why are you so hung up on this chick?
Come on, Frank. This is Arcadia Bay. Gossip is all we have to keep us from hanging ourselves out of boredom.
I don't know.
Frank. Talk, and I'll get my mom to make you something special.
Like what?
Beans.
How about that firehouse chili of hers?
You got it.
The woman you saw. Her name's Sarah. Showed up a few weeks ago, causing all kinds of trouble for all sorts of people.
Like who?
It's a little out of your league, okay?
But what kind of trouble, exactly?
Forget about it, Chloe. Shouldn't have opened my mouth.
Thanks for...
Sarah!
...telling me.
Huh. Whatever. You hear the mill burn down?
Yeah. I heard some stuff about it.
Crazy. My friend Damon runs the place. He lost a lot of money last night.
I wouldn't know anything about that, surely. I don't know anything about Rachel starting the fir- See you later.
Money from what?
Well, he's always had a few things going on. I help him out with some of them.
Don't drown me in the details, Frank.
Lately, he's been doing some stuff that I don't like. But I don't seem to have much leverage with him like I once had. Anyway, you and I have shit to discuss.
Is this about the buck 75?
What?
The money that I owe you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I don't give a shit about that. Wait,
yes.
Do you have it?
Go ask someone richer.
Don't you have richer clients to bother?
I should fucking hope so.
Well, good. Because I need everything I've got.
You're a pain in the ass. I've got bigger problems right now. Open my notebook. Last page. Should be some entries for a kid named Drew. You know him?
Might have heard
North?
Of him.
Yeah, he's... Holy shit. That's a lot of money.
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Apparently football players eat it like candy.
Jesus.
That's smart, I guess. It pays well?
Go Bigfoots. Problem is, Drew owes a grant, and he's not answering my calls. You know what's going on with him?
He's a douchebag, but no, we never talk.
No, I never talk to him. Or his type.
No one's just a type, Price. Anyway, here's the job. I'm taking you to Blackwell. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
But I just got expelled. Can I don't want to go back. What's in it for me?
Yeah, of course, but what's in it for me?
Idiot, you still owe me.
You said forget about it.
So, if I do this, then we're good?
That, and I'll do even better. I'll give you a 10% cut of the money.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
That's a lot of money, Hans.
I'll do it.
What's the matter?
It might be a little tough. I'm not supposed to be at Blackwell. I got expelled this morning.
Congratulations. Still easier for you to go on campus than for me.
Yes.
If you can't even do this, Price.
$100 closer to leaving Arcadia Bay with a bit of cash. And the truck fixed, Rachel and I could really do it. We could leave for good. I'll do it.
Good deal.
BRKBD stands for Bring Really Killer Bodacious Drugs. I guess. Oh, that's the place that... Was it Kate jumped off? Pompidou is an artist. Oh.
Didn't think I'd be back this soon.
Yeah, go Bigfoots, woo!
Well, here goes nothing.
It says caution, wet concrete.
Better hurry up and get into the dorms.
Caution, wet concrete. I really want to write something in it. There's a stick right there. Aw, this guy is cute. Messages. Rachel. Oh god, that's a lot of fucking messages all of a sudden. Back at school yet again. They've got some tents up for dressing rooms. What are you up to? I'm here too, actually, running an errand for my dealer. Oh really? So bad. Come see me when you're done? Yeah, for sure. P.S. I saw that woman that your dad was with coming out of my dealer's RV. What? Apparently she's causing trouble for a lot of people or something. Her name's Sarah. Rachel? I think maybe I prefer not knowing her name. Oh, my bad. No, it's fine. See you soon. Well, see, the way my mind goes with stories like this, I'm always in it for, like, a twist. Or some time travel shit. And because time traveling was something in the first game, I'm like, maybe she's Rachel from the future! And it's like, no, she kissed her dad, and then that's weird. Can I, please? Come on. I already walked in it. My bad. Oops. I can graffiti it with the stick, though. What are we gonna draw? Abandon all hope, Tempest Tossed. Tempest Tossed! I like the alliteration. I also like that my footprints are all over this shit now.
They're just too high risk.
Send these the homeless, Tempest Tossed away. Okay, can I put more footprints in it? Nah, you can only put the one set of footprints through it. Would be hilarious if the whole thing was just footprints. Blackwell totem poster.
Max would have jumped on that photographer position.
So, dude.
What are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be at home, thinking over your endless list of questionable decisions?
Jeez,
dude,
man.
Why do you care about my questionable decisions?
It offends me when intelligence is wasted.
Did Evan just call me intelligent?
It offends you?
Damn straight. Wow. Evan looks really ridiculous.
It offends you. Really? Okay, cool. Thanks, man.
Hey, Evan? As intelligent as you look right now, you can still see that bird from where I'm standing.
I appreciate your concern, but I want to get this shot exactly right. And I've learned something about myself recently.
What's that?
I've learned that if I'm passionate about something, it's probably the right thing to care about. For example, I've been trying to get the students and administration interested in forest fire prevention.
Oh.
That is kind of an odd topic to focus on.
People are so eager to pass on responsibility to anyone else so that they can live comfortable, unworried, and ultimately meaningless lives. You see what happened?
Damn.
Looks like you were right. Go, Evan. You're a hero of the people.
I know you feel like I do. About different things, I'm sure. But you only give a shit about what you give a shit about. I like that. Anyway, you're not supposed to be here. You should leave.
There was some actual decent stuff in that conversation. Caring about what you're passionate about. Hello?
Hey, Samuel. Keeping busy?
Aw, Samuel!
Always, Chloe Price. I didn't think you'd be returning to these hallowed halls so soon.
They're really creepy! Soon to be
neither
serial killer!
I have the feeling it wasn't the books or bricks of Blackwell that led you back.
It's fucking weird.
What?
You're here for someone. A special someone, yes?
You're here to partake in the ritual, aren't you, Chloe Price? Yes. The seventh seal is almost complete.
He's so fucking weird. Rachel.
What do you think of Rachel Amber?
Rachel Amber is a dragon made of diamonds.
That's, deep. Do you just make this shit up on the fly, or do you, like, write it down beforehand?
Are you angry all the time because you like the way it feels? Or is it merely a desperate defense against experiencing true intimacy with others?
Oh, shit. I've gotta go.
I've gotta go, man. It's been real.
Okay, I'm not talking to anybody
else. Be kind to yourself, Chloe Price.
Everybody else is like my fucking psychiatrist. I'm not talking to anybody else. I'm just going to get the stupid thing. The more people I talk to, the more it's like, are you mad at yourself or are you mad at the world? Open up your heart, Chloe.
Figures.
Damn it.
Looks like my options are become a master lockpicker or swipe someone's keys.
Steph. You got some keys? Fine, I'll talk to Steph. Only cause she's cool. What's up, Steph?
Hey, Steph.
Whoa. Hey, Calamastia. Your shirt looks like the tea leaves they used to tell people's fortunes.
How's my future looking?
Bright and sunny.
Surprised to see me on parole?
I told you Wells was out to get you. That text was a rare courtesy, by the way. I don't normally get involved in other people's dumb decisions.
Good choice.
Thanks for trying, but skipping yesterday was totally worth it.
Skipping with Rachel Amber does have an appeal.
Well, yeah.
So, what are you doing here?
Seeing the Tempest?
I figured I'd see the Tempest.
For real? You?
Yeah, I know. It's not really my thing. Kinda hoping it's a shit show.
What the hell? I'm the stage manager.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I think I knew that. My bad.
Oops. You better mean it. Honestly, the show's really good. It's worth seeing.
I'm sure it is.
Obviously, Rachel's fantastic, but everyone else is pretty impressive, too. You get to see a totally different side of everyone, especially the guys.
Okay. I'm intrigued. Go on.
Like, Hayden's so annoying, but when he puts on that crown, he's actually very princely. And Nathan is Caliban? There's so much depth there.
Right. Depth. Yeah, well, good luck with all of that. Maybe I'll see you later.
Oh, hey. I wanted to ask you something.
Shoot!
Shoot. I've been planning to make a move on Rachel, but not if you two were together.
Aw.
Make a move?
So, are you? I mean, that's Rachel's business. Or maybe yours and Rachel's business. But if you feel comfortable telling me...
Oh. Ugh! Oh! God! You think we're together? Is that the rumor that's been going around?
You think we're... together?
You've been hanging out a lot, which I know might not mean anything, but I like to be extra careful about these things.
I don't know. It's confusing.
Yeah, I can imagine. You ever want to talk to me, Chloe, you know you can, right?
I'll see you later, Steph.
Have fun storming the castle.
Okay, I need to get some fucking keys.
Just... ugh.
Is anyone else interested in starting an interfaith discussion group? Open to anyone and everyone. Looks like someone got rejected from the Vortex Club. Let's celebrate and learn from each other. We are Blackwell's greatest resource. Looks like someone got... oh, I get it. Weird.
Evan, you got some keys lying around on you? Maybe if I turn on a sprinkler?
Blackwell Academy. Conserving water since... Now, Evan's subject for the day. Better you than me, Bird.
You shouldn't be on campus, Chloe.
Damn it. Okay, who am I getting keys from? Oh, maybe Samuel. Maybe there's just keys lying around in here. Ooh. Yes.
Bingo. If only those keys were unsupervised. What's Samuel working on? The sprinklers?
Okay, maybe let's do some with the sprinklers. Hey, Bird. Sorry. Can't do anything with the fucking sprinklers.
If Samuel's working on the sprinklers, some damage here might get his attention. But Evan is right there.
Can I scare the bird away? Sorry.
Hey!
Shit. I wanted you to go the other way. Like, as far as possible, the other way.
Don't scare the bird again. Oh, the poor bird! Shit.
Time for a fresh start.
Okay. Can I scare you this way? Here we go.
Here we go.
He's not questioning this at all. I want to scare you towards the totem. Get out of here, bird! You damn bird!
Gotcha.
That makes a cooler picture.
Oh, perfect.
See?
You're welcome.
Much better picture. See you later. I'ma just do a little smashy smash. Sorry, hit my microphone. A little smashy smash. There we go. Nice.
Awesome. Now I just have to wait for Samuel to turn on the... That works.
Hey, Samuel, it's broken! Samuel! You see, this is broken! Samuel's gonna come fix it, and then I'm gonna be the one in charge. Now go! Get the keys! Go, go, go! Here we go. We're off. We're at the races. What the hell is that thing? Oh, it's another sprinkler.
Sorry, nice. Samuel.
Now I got the keys to the rooms, I got the keys to his car, I got the keys to his house.
Time to find Drew's room.
Just smell them. Whichever one smells like the most amount of shit is Drew's room.
No time like the present.
On the front of the dorms it says, "Welcome, sluts."
Chloe?
Oh, hey! Hey! Skip Matthews.
Hey, Skip. How's it going?
Not that it isn't great to see you and all, but what are you doing here?
You know.
Didn't you just get expelled?
I'm visiting a friend.
Relax. I'm just visiting a friend.
I really can't just let you go in.
Oh, I'm going inside.
I'm going inside, dude. You're just gonna have to let this slide.
Yes, Skip. Skip Matthews.
I don't think I can. In fact, I think I have to ask you to state your official business or else vacate Blackwell property.
Skip, come on. Skip, level with me. Skip,
may I call you Trip? Skip, but I've got to get inside. Maybe if I make him really uncomfortable, he'll feel guilty and let me pass.
Here we go. Teenage assuasion skills are.
What's my official business? Women's business, Skip. As in, my uterus? I need to use the restroom. Glad you asked.
What? No. No, it's my job to ask, Chloe.
That's not cool,
Fuck!
Skip. You realize that, right?
Chloe, I just have this feeling like you're up to... Wait. You talked me into letting you into the bathroom this morning, and then you tagged the entire friggin' place.
What?
I messed it up.
No, fuck it. I totally did that.
Wells raked me over the coals for that. Ugh. Time to go.
Or what?
Man.
What are you gonna do, Skip? Because unless you're prepared to drag me off this campus, I'm going inside.
Chloe, enough. This is my job. Just go.
Fuck.
You have never respected me. You and all your smug little classmates. I am so tired of being shit on by high schoolers. You know what? I'm done. I'm done with this stupid rent-a-cop job. Just do whatever the fuck you want, Chloe.
Whoa, Skip.
Matthews, I've gotten reports Jesus. Of an unknown vehicle in the parking lot.
That's funny. Because I've gotten reports about how your head is really far up your ass.
What did you just say?
Damn. Matthews. Skip really lost it there.
Wait, so I failed, didn't I get in anyway? But Junker, how's it going? Have you found it yet? Chill out, man. It's been like 5 minutes. It's been 20. Well, okay, I'm on it. Hurry up.
Time to find Drew's room.
Jesus. Skip Matthews! I kept saying that you're a fake human being and a fake name and all that shit, but Skip Matthews? Skip Matthews, really? You're pretty damn cool, Skip Matthews. Shouldn't leave the keys like that. It'd probably lock me in.
All right, which one is Drew's room?
ABFW alert. Forest Watch. Now 50% contained. Huh. Additional road closures, check local media. Thou shalt not pass. That's not Drew's room. Break a leg tonight. Great game. You're a beast. Need to talk to you, Zach.
Yep. Definitely Drew's room.
Hell yep. Knock. Drew! Drew, come on out there now! Are you in there? He's not in there. Let's go. Drew Barrymore?
No one's home.
Sick.
He has the same computer background. He also has a jar of peanut butter.
Good. Drew's not here. Okay. If I were Drew, where would I hide my money?
Drew plays the figurines. Dude, you're cool.
Mikey's figures.
Oh.
Playing that game yesterday was actually fun.
Mikey's his brother.
Is the money in there?
Probably.
All right. Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code.
Is it 1, 2, 3, 4?
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
I was sure. That's foolproof. That's everyone's password all the time.
Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football.
Huh. You got a scholarship into Oregon State University.
I didn't realize Drew was this good at sports. I bet he can't wait to get out of Arcadia Bay.
Thank you so much for your consideration and the generous scholarship offer. I regret to inform you that I've chosen to attend Oregon State in the fall. He's rejecting scholarships.
Lying. Looks like Drew sells happy pills to his fellow meatheads.
Hey, bro, you have any more happy pills? I'm beat as hell. You saw me take that hit for you last night, right? Huh, no one gets in my boy's grill on my watch. Huh, but hook me up, will you? Something just to take the edge off is all I need. See you later, dude. Sod.
So many folks are shit out of luck around here.
At least Drew has some prospects.
Okay, I thought some of the thing would be in there.
Look at that. More numbers.
11, 20, 36. Wait, what do you mean more numbers?
A lot of numbers on here. Would Drew really use something like this for a lock combo?
1212? I mean, can't hurt to try, right?
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
Okay, so could be a combination of those ones. 11, 20, 36.
We might have failed to kill you, Durgeron. But something tells me Mikey's not through. Yet.
Bad guys don't usually look so obvious, but this is still awesome.
Sergeant Blood versus Maniacal. Whoa!
Awesome.
Dr. Timebot, the Jurassic Edition. Dude, that's pretty dope.
Plenty of possible combinations here.
1992, 1996, 0832. There's too many fucking numbers. There must be, like...
They look so happy.
Aw, that's cute. There must be something that hints towards one of them being true.
Looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew.
Yeah, let's just try 1996.
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
1992?
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
I don't know what it is.
A lot of numbers on here. Would Drew really use something like this for a lock combo?
Must be a number somewhere that it alludes to. 11, 20, 36. If I add them up, does it lead to something? Man, I'm gonna dip.
I didn't realize Drew was this good at sport.
Any numbers in any of this?
Frank wasn't lying. So many folks are shit out of luck around here. At least plenty of possible combinations here. I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
Varsity awards dinner.
Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football.
A college ship? I don't know what the code is. There's too many options.
A lot of numbers on here. Would Drew really use something like this for a lock combo?
I mean, you're being awfully presumptuous about that one.
I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
16, yeah, 0516. Maybe. Probably not. Oh, I thought I got it.
Might actually need some help with this one.
Random question. I don't know. Probably Mikey. When's Mikey's birthday? Not for a while. 1227. 1227?
1227. Worth a shot.
Did he really make the combination his brother's birthday?
Yes.
Oh, that's adorable.
This is kind of fun.
But at least we're in.
Oh. Did little Drew beat you up too? Jackpot.
Nice.
I'm kind of good at this.
Kinda good at stealing shit. We're gonna get caught, aren't we?
Okay. Got the money. Time to bust out of here.
Oh, shit. Oh, it's Mikey.
Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
Cool story, bro.
No reason. Just roaming the halls.
Were you wanting to play more tabletop games?
Yes!
Bro, we gotta go. Yesterday wasn't enough? You wanna go another round? Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff, let's move.
What's going on?
Drew, relax. Slow down.
Oh, it's the other guy.
Shit.
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
What's going on?
Drew, what's going on?
Don't worry about it. Stay in here and don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
That was the dude who was in the picture with Frank, isn't it?
You know what's going on?
Damon, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Shit.
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look, it's spring season. We just started two-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me a grand. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now. I heard about your dad's job, by the way. Tough times. Yeah. Bet a grand would mean a lot to him.
Oh, shit.
Where's my money, Drew?
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm gonna...
Where is it?
Please! Just give me one week...
You're just going to lie there? I thought football players were supposed to be tough. Sorry to have to do this, kid! No one steals from me! No one.
Fuck. Fuck!
I hate when it makes me decide. He told me not to open the door.
Let me go. No. Your brother said to stay inside. It'll be okay, Mikey. It'll be okay.
Damn, you are one tough kid. Fuck you. Yeah? Well, what about this? Good luck running on that knee now.
No!
Well, I'm done. Get my money. Or maybe it'll be your little brother I talk to next. See you soon.
Oh, Jesus.
Drew! It's okay. I'm okay.
I was afraid if I opened up the door, he'd beat up Mikey.
Thank you, Chloe. Thank you.
I have to give him the money back. My fucking conscience is riddled right now.
Here. It sounds like you could use this.
You took this from my locker?
Frank asked me to. I didn't know. I'm sorry, man.
My dad. He needs this money. Way more than that asshole does. Thanks.
Drew, you need to get to the hospital.
Don't tell anyone about this, okay?
Yeah. No. No way. What? What are you going to do?
About Damon? I don't know. One day at a time.
I hear you.
That fucking sucked! I mean, these choice-based games usually course-correct themselves anyway, but still, to have to see him go through that... I'm sorry, Drew. Are we actually gonna get to go see the play? Backstage. It's very cozy. Is that Rachel?
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back here.
What's going on? Chloe, it's Steph. I'm on my way to the hospital. Mikey told me what happened. Poor Drew, I'm still stunned. Thank you for what you did. Shit, I'm glad you're going. Let me know if I can help more. Thanks, I will. You know what? I gotta give this table some props.
Did Doug dig...
No, this isn't Rachel.
Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig
David's garden? David's garden? How's your super long errand going? Yo, crazy shit happened in Drew's room. Like, really bad. Oh no, are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Yeah, later. Don't worry until the show is over. I'm backstage. Great, on my way. Wait, so you're not here?
Rachel?
Raquel? Victoria. I'm not here. What are you doing? Are you fucking up the tea? Are you drugging Rachel? Are you being a hashtag bitch?
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
Yeah, no shit, dog.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
I just talked to Damon. He said he had to come down hard. Didn't see you. What happened? Did you find the money? Price, where's the money? This is serious. Quit fucking around. Unless you're dead, reply. Let's meet tomorrow, have answers. God, people text really fast in this. Aw, that's a cute little mirror with a lot of fairy lights. Hello! It's me! You wanna see me do a dance?
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
What did you put in? Wait, let's look at the portfolio first.
Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer. Why does that piss me off so much?
Oh, that's a nice picture.
Whoa, dude. Whoa. They're awesome.
Oh. Muscle relaxers?
Zule Pharmaceuticals Soma. It's a video game.
Coming, Rachel?
Hurry now before your tea gets...
Hey!
What are you doing here?
How's it going?
This area is for cast and crew only.
I'm here for Rachel! Tea Tainter!
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever.
Hey, Boo.
Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night, as a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks.
Tell Rachel to distract. I mean, I don't see the problems with just telling her outright, because what do I have to lose? A fucking relationship with Victoria? But I kind of want to distract Victoria, because something probably go wrong if I tell Rachel outright, right? Plus, I kind of want to see what happens if I swap the teas.
Hold up. Did you hear that?
Hear what? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I hear it now. It sounds like Mr. Keaton's calling for you.
He is? Oh, he probably wants my thoughts on the set dressing. Okay, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
What's going on? Bitch, dosed your tea. That is the least surprising thing ever. What should we do?
Switch the cups? Why not? Let's see
problem
Victoria
solved.
Get a little... I feel a little woozy.
Damn. Chloe Price. What would I do without you?
Have super relaxed muscles, I guess.
Mr. Keaton's busy with Nathan. I'm sure he'll call on my aesthetic sensibility soon. In the meantime, let us drink.
Let us drink!
I mean, yes, let's. Clink.
Oh, make sure you drink it all. Your instrument will thank you.
Thank you, guitar.
I am so grateful to have such a kind and caring friend as you, Victoria.
Aw, samesies.
Samesies?
Samesies, too.
Oh, you are going to
anyway,
be passed
I'll
out.
I'll see you out there. Break a leg.
Relax a muscle.
So, that happened?
Just when I thought this day couldn't get any batshit crazier.
Oh, hey, that's mine. The gloomiest shirt of the bunch. How did I know you were gonna pick that one?
I guess Prospera knows all.
Sweet Carnation, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
Why?
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel.
Oh no! Whatever shall we do?
Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Oh! Devil spot!
Mr. Creighton, I have revelations to reveal. Rachel Amber is on drugs. Look at her. Her face is so blurry and pretty. She's clearly been drugged. I mean, drugged herself. She loves drugs. Don't you?
Alas, 'twould seem that thy fair lady
Touché, fates.
Hath been on
Touché.
The drug.
What? No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
Oh.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
Oh God, no, please no.
The cynic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
But I don't know the lines.
She is indeed.
Oh, I've had
Tell
nightmares
me, my
about
dear,
this.
Have you ever acted before?
Oh.
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic
this
at
is my
it.
Nightmare.
My dear. What if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
That's worse!
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Oh, brilliant.
Damn.
Oh my God! Oh, you look pretty good!
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
Dude, that's a cool outfit! You look like a bird! Does she look cool? I'm into it! Oh God, laughing made me cry. Let's look in the mirror. Oh, let's graffiti the mirror.
When life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit.
Hey, you know, put it on your lips. Death or tragedy? Death.
Got it.
Got it. Gaddy! Oh my God. Vanity Fair.
I got an Achievo.
That's pretty cool.
No. I am not just being dramatic.
She drew a noose around her neck and some eyes. That definitely does signify death.
Looks like I'm late. As usual.
Okay. How am I supposed to fill the spot if I don't know any of the lines? Do I just go out there and then just be like, oh, what hath thee? Is there a script around here that I could at least peruse over? Left mouse button to leave. No, I'm not ready.
Time
script!
For my big... I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
All hail, great master. I come to answer thy best pleasure. Wait a second. Do I actually have to, like, pick these lines as they come up? Could I actually cheat this? Could I actually take pictures of the lines and then regurgitate them? I'm a fucking do that. I'm doing that. That's... The game gave me an option, and I'm sticking to it. I mean, I just memorized them. I've already drugged someone, I'm already in too deep, and I'm trying to keep all the lines in my head. Or on my phone.
By accident, most strange.
This is
Bountiful
me.
Fortune hath mine enemies brought okay. to the shore.
Okay. Okay.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep.
These are not on the thing.
'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose.
Come away, servant. Come I'm ready
away,
now.
Servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
Oh, that's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Dude, I'm gonna
Approach
fucking kill this.
My Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Okay.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless.
She already knows them!
Generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I boarded the king's ship. Totally from memory.
I boarded the king's ship.
I flamed amazement.
Every cabin, I flamed amazement.
I got it.
The fire.
From my memory.
Cracks of sulfurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves, tremble.
Yes!
My brave spirit,
Who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man
that
leaped from his ship and cried.
Oh, shit. And cried, "Hell is empty!" I remember that from my brain.
Cried, "Hell is empty, and all the devils are here."
Huh? Yes! This is so fucking bad.
But are they, Ariel, safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Oh, shit. Climb to top of shipwreck. Okay.
I'm definitely supposed to do
Chloe,
something
stand
with
here.
This.
I just wander around until people, like, tell me what to do. There, I did it.
Not a hair perished. And, as thou baddest me,
I'm an actor.
I have dispersed them about the isle.
Yes. In troops.
In troops.
Wow.
Bravo.
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed. But there's more work.
Is there more toil?
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
My liberty! That one I remembered.
My liberty.
Indeed.
Ew.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line. Is it? What's going on?
Uh-oh. Oh, God. That's not her line. Oh, balls!
But thou assured my freedom. Didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script.
It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new, fun, you'll tire of me. And, then I'll be alone.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
It's getting real now. This isn't script. This is actual feels.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend. For but a little longer, I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes. And when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased. Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
You crushed it. So good.
You're a born thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year. And the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
Thanks.
Oh, that was
what
cute.
What the hell just happened?
The strangeness of
was
your story
that real?
Put heaviness in me.
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On! Hello!
As wicked dew as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Shit! He's crying!
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fuck you!
Poor Nathan.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
This shit got real.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up!
Oh, shit!
Traitor!
Do you love me?
Oh, heaven, oh, earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
So beautiful.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
Bravo! Bravo!
I have no idea what happened. What the fuck is going on? This is what the game is now. You're just watching a play. I mean, your outfits are fucking cool. I want Rachel's outfit. That horned mask looks awesome. Visionary! Oscar!
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah?
Yes!
How dead?
Hella dead.
Hella dead. Oh my god. You ruined it. I was rooting for you, Chloe. Take your bows, everybody. Take your bow. You did good. All of you. You. All of you out there. Oh, wait.
Who is she?
Seriously, who is she?
I was shitting myself.
In the dead of night, I'll meet you in my sleep.
He was shitting himself.
That dude owes me.
In the morning light, you wake up next to me. Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam.
Where are you guys?
And
here they are.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders? I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You know, you. Like, seriously, I love nights after a show.
Is it always like this?
Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline.
I've been there.
So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? You were literally perfect tonight. I was blown away.
I think I'm just happy it's over. The last 12 hours have been freaking intense.
You've gone through so much shit today.
Right now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical.
Oh, I can say something sweet or hold her hand. I'ma hold that hand. God, you guys are cute.
Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day.
But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Parents?
I know our parents have been shitty, but we can't just leave them.
That doesn't sound like Chloe Price.
Her mom is nice, though.
But I'm the only one my mom has left.
You're right. What am I saying? She's got David now.
What about money?
What about money?
I thought you were a high-rolling criminal now.
I collected the money Frank wanted, but then I gave it back to Drew instead.
It sounded like he needs it more.
No shit. But man, I'm not looking forward to what Frank has to say when he finds out.
We'll figure it out, Chloe. Anyway, I've got more than enough to start us out. I always get birthday money from my dad. Or should I say, hush money.
We're gonna have to just do it, aren't we?
Any more questions?
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Saskatchewan! That's a good place to go! The open road! New York!
Los Angeles!
Let's go to LA! Let's make it! Show business!
Why don't you show me LA?
Perfect. 60 degrees every night, you and me on the Santa Monica Pier, gorging on food truck food, smoking up, looking at the moon shining on the waves.
Sounds hella
and
cool.
A beautiful blonde man will sit next to us and smile at you.
Yeah, okay.
He'll say, I like your eyes. And I'll say, back off. She's with me.
You're full of shit.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Ooh. Oh, I can make it happen. Oh, a tattoo or your bracelet? Fuck that. Fuck that.
How about, Oh.
It's happening! Oh, finally! Jesus!
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
Aw, they're so adorable! They like each other so much! That's cute.
Holy shit.
Is it snowing? Oh.
What is this stuff?
That's ash.
I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
If you want to, I'm ready. Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff from my house.
Did her head just glitch?
Or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
That sounds perfect.
Nice house. Damn. We gonna go on a road trip, dog. My heart is so full of emotion right now. Your poor mom's, though. What was that?
Oh, you're home.
Oh, hey, cheater. I mean, Dad.
Rose, Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Oh, yeah. Last time we met was not the best, huh?
Our star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
Is?
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were. I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, yeah. Honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must? I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Chicken out of king.
Thanks, but I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans? I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
Totally.
Totally. Your parents love me.
They're good at coming off that way, but don't let your guard down. And Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know,
that I would normally say.
Yeah, don't be
exactly.
Don't be Chloe.
Just some quality time with the Ambers.
Man, this is a long episode.
What could possibly go wrong?
Excuse me. Steph has texted me. Steph, what up, girl? Heard you're in The Tempest. Yeah, it was kind of a big deal. I believe it. Everyone says the show was awesome. You get medals for two good deeds today. Drew's okay. Mikey will text you an update in a bit. Oh, shit. Tell them both I'm pulling for them. Hey. James, was it?
Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
You know the girl you were kissing in the park?
Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're fond of her as well.
You ever feel like she's so awesome at everything that you just want to shake her? Yeah. Me neither.
Yeah, it's stupid what I just said. No, never mind.
So, you're a district attorney, huh?
I'm your district attorney.
So I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
What would you be arrested for?
Oh, Jesus.
It was a joke. Not a good one, clearly.
Gotta go.
Duty calls. Good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Captain A-hole. I'ma just go help Mom. Hey, Mom.
Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight. You borrowed that shirt from Rachel. We call it the Rorschach shirt. What do you see?
I see a skull.
I definitely see a skull.
Interesting. Well, wash it before you bring it back.
Are you saying I smell? Rose? Not all of us can have a fragrant name.
So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight. Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age.
Me too.
I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. So, you putting me to work, or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
You're a riot, Chloe.
Thanks.
All right, Chloe. You've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before.
Yeah,
no skeletons.
I think we
lots
can do
of
it.
Shiny dishes, though.
Ooh, Mikey. Hey, Chloe. Yeah. Drew's out of surgery. In pain, but okay. Holy shit, Mikey. I'm so sorry. It's okay. You stuck with me. Plus, you saved our money. We owe you. Wish I could have helped more. Hey, Steph says you were in the play? What? I've had a busy day. Most heroes do. Oh, right in the feels.
In
stuff to the table with you.
Away, plate! Just throw them at the table. Look at my sexy walk. Shazam. Chloe, Justin Williams' mom just called me. Were you in the play tonight? I would have liked to see that. Kinda just happened. I know it was last minute. I'm glad you're doing well. It would be nice to see you tonight. Are you coming home? Please, Chloe, I miss you. Oh, fucking mom's gonna make me cry. Oh. Is that everything?
Yes, Chloe?
Integrity, honesty, loyalty.
What?
It's on your lawn.
Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife.
What's it like being married to the DA?
The dick
ass.
Much
like being married to anyone else, I imagine.
But with a lot more secrets, right?
Secrets?
Like attorney-client privilege and all that.
Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them.
Of course not.
On the wall behind her, it says something like, the more things you learn to like, the happier you will be. That's a nice little motto.
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, see? Could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine.
Something else?
Why do you want a fucking drink, bitch?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Sherry's gross.
Okay. One, two, three, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Besides all my bad behavior rubbing off on her?
I don't know. I don't know anything.
Another joke.
You tell me. It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
And you were all too eager to play into our expectations. In my experience, that's a tactic people use to cover for someone else. Rachel is her own person. She's responsible for her actions.
Strict dad.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks.
Sherry, was it? Sherry with a sight of guilt?
Yes, Chloe?
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding. It's the fancy-looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
Chloe, why? These are not the people to make those jokes to. Save the A material for when it really matters, for the people who really want to hear it. Also, James would like a sherry. It seems like he's not fond of his wife anymore.
Glasses. Damn. The Ambers are fancy as shit.
Sure are. It would be cool if their glasses were actually made of amber.
It's the triangle-shaped one.
Basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
Now you're tongue in my ear holes. His setting. Which one's his setting? Ah, head at the table, of course. She rubbed it on her boot! On her butt! Oh, classic.
Yes, Chloe?
What else?
Can we just have dinner?
I feel like I'm getting good at this.
Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the-
It's cool. I've got my own.
Oh.
You never know when you'll need to light a candle, right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think.
A paragon of preparedness!
Time to light some candles and bless this joint up a bit.
I like the shit out of these candles. Look at me go. 1, 2, 3, Zippo!
The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah. Are we gonna get a big revelation here at the end? It's very late to be having dinner.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I wish. Rachel's all honors. I'm still trying to get into remedial... What's it called? Vocabulary.
Ironic.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's sure strange, just like life.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me.
Because
you're the DA, of course.
The dickass!
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Ooh, shit.
Arson. Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
Oh. I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open.
Chloe's
gonna
blurt it out, isn't she?
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family.
Oh.
Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for.
Whoa.
And never, ever taken for granted.
Sure. I am not attacking James, not in this instance. I love to be the provocator and the instigator, but... It's Rachel's fight.
Yeah, that's super true. And also remember, Rachel, that even when shit's like the lamest ever, you can always run away from whatever's bothering you. As long as you just keep calm.
An interesting philosophy, Chloe.
Yes, indeed. Not one that I would endorse, however. I favor confronting my problems head on. But to each their own, I suppose.
Oh, fucking blow me.
Rachel?
Oh, shit!
Crap. I'm so clumsy.
Smooth.
Rachel, can you come help me find another fork? Chloe.
Oh.
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad. You're a hypocrite. Okay? I know. You lying, cheating,
piece of shit, motherfucker.
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel, honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Think we saw? Are you trying to gaslight us? There's no thinking involved. We saw you locking lips with some other woman. Best part is, she and I use the same drug dealer.
Not important!
That's enough! You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of
you. Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's okay. Enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
She gonna do the screamy magic again? Oh, shit.
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
What? The fuck? What the geez?
On the place that you left.
I've heard this song before.
Our minds are troubled by the emptiness. Destroy the middle, it's a waste of time.
Why is there a subtitle right there?
From the perfect start to the finish line. And if you're still breathing, you're the lucky ones. Cause most of us are heaving through corrupted
lungs. Oh, that's not good.
Setting fire to our insides for fun.
I really like this song, by the way. Just in general, not hearing it here. I've heard it before, this.
The lovers, the
that was your... That was her mom? Oh, Joyce. Joyce got the worst of all of this. So, if that's her mom, then who is Rose? Just her stepmom? But then why was he kissing her mom? Also, what? Jesus. Oh, that's so cute.
Then you are the lucky one.
I don't know who you are, but he needed that, and that's really nice.
Someone.
Oh, that's made me tear up.
Setting fire to our insides for fun. To distract our
now that you say it, she does look a lot like Rachel. I think the subtitles are broken right now. Oh, man! Jesus! Fuck! That was a humdinger! That was like 3 hours of what the hell is going on? Okay, not bad. That was starting to pick up a bit. For the first episode, I was kind of like, eh. It's okay, but nothing fantastic. And even some parts of this episode, I was like, I'm not feeling this.
And there's a lot of moments when they make you go off and do pointless shit and making you go around and collect stuff just so they can have the video gamey element there. Which I feel like the game doesn't even really need to do. I think these games would be fine if they were just kind of visual novel type of things and you just had to input on your choices. I don't think it needs too much input, because sometimes the input that's in it is kind of trivial and doesn't really go anywhere. There wasn't a whole lot of, like, choices that seemed to have effect later on this time. Or maybe they were just subtly hidden and didn't, like, overtly say, like, Telltale being like, Rachel will remember that. Huh. I don't really know what that signifies for our character's next episode. I think there's only one episode left. There's only three episodes in this because it's a prequel. But I don't know what that signifies for Rachel and Chloe, the fact that that's her mom. I don't know the implications of that, but I'm curious to find out why. I'm glad that the two of them kiss this time. Sure, I'm the one who said kiss. But, I mean, it just feels like that's where it's going anyway, and everybody kind of wants the characters to be together. So it's really nice to actually see it come to fruition. So that part I liked. The play section... And at the time I was like, eh, that's a little weird, but now that it's all over, it's kind of like, yeah, our writer Ashley Birch. At least she's still writing for the game. Ashley Birch used to be the lady who did the voice for Chloe. And you can definitely tell the voice acting in this game, not the best. It's a little hokey, it's a little cringy. You can tell where the lines are recorded next to each other, where they're saying a sentence, and then you can tell where the line was cut off and they didn't continue, they just recorded the next line. So it sounds a little smashed together sometimes, so it kind of pulls you out of the moment. But could be a whole lot worse. The dialogue, the writing is a bit all over the place still. Sometimes it works, because sometimes it's like, ah, I get it, you're being silly on purpose. But then other times they're trying to be serious and it sounds a little silly. Because it's like, ah, real people don't talk like that. But overall, decent episode. I like that a lot. Thank you guys for being here. Any of you who are here live, thank you guys for being here. Really means a lot to me that you sit here for 3 hours and watch me play this. Any of you at home who are watching it after the fact, don't be sad that you missed the stream. You're still here with us in spirit. And thank you for being here and watching the episode as well. And I'm curious to know what your thoughts are going to be in the comments based on this episode. The music in this is probably the best part of the whole episode. Music in this episode is really, really damn good. And that's another reason why I live streamed it, to try and kind of get around some of that, because last time it was a pain in the ass to try and upload episodes of this, and the fact that there was a full-on copyrighted song at the end and throughout probably would have been a big pain in the ass as well. But curious to see how this is all going to end. I'm going to end the stream now because I've been going for a while and I am starving. But seriously, thank you guys for being here and hanging out. I want to see what the choices are. You took the blame for Rachel, 81%, that's curious. And also, I'm excited about these statistics, because normally when I play these episodes, it's right after, like, a couple hundred people have played the game, or reviewers have played the game, so now I can actually see what my results are for, like, general populace. You emptied your pockets at David's request? Of course, because I had nothing in them. You stayed with Mikey? Okay, 67% of people. And you asked Rachel for a kiss. Yay! I'm in the majority for all of these. Normally I fuck it all up. You didn't talk to Elliot about the play. Why not? You agreed to start over with David. You put the singing man on the dashboard of the truck. Yes. You didn't pay off your debt to Frank. 98%. So a lot of people gave the money back to Drew. You didn't tell Steph that Rachel was single. You returned Drew's money to him. Huh. So I guess 31% of people, that's the only one so far that I haven't been in the majority for. Man, people didn't return Drew's money? Ice cold. Heartless. Ruthless. But I respect it. You returned Drew's money to him, and then... So, the 69% of people who didn't return money Drew to him, a bunch of them kept the money for themselves. Okay. I see how it is. You didn't give Samantha advice. Oh, I didn't even see Samantha. That's the girl at the end who you told Samantha to help Nathan. Oh, that's so cute that she waited around for him at the end because he got bullied on stage. Which, I mean, leads a lot to what his character turned out to be in the actual season, because that's... He got severely bullied and then he brought a gun to school and wanted to shoot Chloe, and then Max found her powers. You tricked Victoria before the play, or you confronted Victoria?
Same outcome, really, but the tricking one was far more funny. You told Rachel you'd like to go to Los Angeles. That's curious. Wonder why the majority of people picked LA and not these. Rachel attacked James at dinner. You attacked James at dinner. Yeah, I felt like that was the right thing to do because it's Rachel's fight. And as much as I wanted to attack him, I felt like that's where it was going anyway. So let Rachel do it. It's her moment.
Shit. Shit. Shit.
Ooh. Truck had no problem starting that time. Episode 3, Hell is Empty. Chloe's story continues in the next episode. Buy more episodes now. Please buy more episodes now. Well, if I bought the second episode, there's no more episodes to buy. Hell is Empty. Awake, Brave New World, and Hell is Empty. Huh, curious. Okay, so I'll be back with the next episode eventually. I don't know when that's going to be. It's been like a month, just over a month since the first episode came out. So second episode came out now, and third episode will probably be out before the end of the year. So I'm excited to play that. But again, thank you guys so much for being here. I'm gonna end the stream now, I have to click off, but that was a hell of a night. Thank you guys for spending this time with me here in this moment. And again, if you're watching at home after the fact, I hope you had a great night and I hope you enjoyed the episode. But thanks guys, I'm a go. Thank you guys. I guess I should just do the outro. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, punch that like button in the face like a boss. And
high fives all around.
Whoopish, whoopish. But thank you guys. They will see all you dudes in the next video. Like, this is awkward. Now it's just me sitting here. I just realized at the end, there's no outro to play. Okay.